Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Is Clark's occupancy theory the only way to model ligand response curves? No way. Clark's theory is very similar to the Michaelis-Menten equation, but let's be clear that receptors are not the same as enzymes. They are far more complex. If we try to fit all receptors into an enzyme-like box, then some of the receptors will not fit. Additional receptor theories have been developed to accommodate these outlier receptors that don't seem to work well with Clark's theory. One theory is the two-state theory. In the two-state theory, the receptor is in equilibrium between two states, one relaxed, R, and the other tensed. When in the tensed state, the receptor causes a response. What are the benefits of the two-state theory? Well, two-state theory immediately accommodates constitutive activity. In a normal state, the receptor, in the absence of a ligand, may have some fraction in the tensed state. That looks completely reasonable. That fraction in the tensed state will cause a response. How does two-state theory include ligands? Agonists bind more strongly to the tense state, and the equilibrium shifts to the right to give more response. Antagonists bind both states in an equal manner, in a manner that does not change the equilibrium or response. The silent antagonists. Inverse agonists favor the relaxed state and reduce any constitutive response. That is the two-state theory. Another theory is rate theory. Rate theory is about the kinetics of receptor binding. In rate theory, the receptor can be free or bound by the ligand. Neither the free nor bound form causes a response. The response occurs as the receptor is binding to the ligand. Therefore, the important action of the ligand is its initial contact with the receptor. We need to think about rate constants, K on and K off. K on is important because that causes the response. K off is also important because the ligand cannot activate a receptor again until it comes off to regenerate the free receptor. Rate theory is a bit more complex because in chemistry, we are accustomed more to thinking in terms of equilibrium constants rather than rate constants. Regardless, rate theory can explain the behavior of some receptors, when Clark's theory is a poor model. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please post any questions you have in the comments section. Take care.